Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Premier League Fantasy Football and welcome to my video. In today's video I want to look at my team, seeing how well they performed in game week 29, then we move ahead to game week 30. So if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe and drop a like on the video as it helps my channel out a lot. So here we go. So as you can see, for game week 29, I got 138 points. I played the bench boost and it has paid off. Above the average of 80, and I made 3 transfers going into this game week. So that's a minus 4 point hit. Let's have a quick look at my transfers. So I removed Sanchez, a player that, you know, lost his spot. So I had to remove him. It's a shame because I was trying to get into, you know, go into this game week without taking a hit. Yeah, I had to remove him and I bought in David De Gea. And so far, so good. 2 points against Newcastle and 6 against Brentford. And moving forward, I think I can see a couple of clean sheets for Manchester United. The other player that I removed was one of the Arsenal midfielders, which was Martinelli. It was a risky move, and I didn't want to remove all of my Arsenal players because they had a really good home fixture against Leeds. And as you can see, they won 4-0, so it was a good result for them. Martinelli, though, got only 1 assist, so only 5 points, so it didn't hurt my ranks too much. However, Fernandes was a massive, massive disappointment. Was expecting him to get more, playing kind of like in that central midfield position where it's just defending a lot. It's not where we want him, you know, it's not what we want to see, right? But in the next coming game weeks, that could change, and I hope it changes, because these fixtures here, like Everton at home, away fixture against Nottingham Forest, looks really, really good on paper for him to return. Now, Harry Kane was a big, big decision for me to remove him. And, you know, the only reason why I removed him is because I wanted to free up the funds. I wanted to have that funds in the next coming game weeks to get, like, Salah and Haaland back into the team. So I thought, you know what, let me remove him and just hope for the best. He did return with 7, so I'm quite happy that it was only 7. And yeah, the fixtures are looking good. I guess I could still bring him back into the team, but we'll see. However, I brought in Solanke here, as you can see, got me 9 points against Fulham. That helped a lot. That was a big, big, big differential of like, what, 2.1% owned there. And he only got 2 points against Brighton. So the transfers worked. It has gained me a decent amount of points and it has freed up some funds, so I'm quite happy on how things went. And as you can see, from 60,000, I mentioned that, you know, after game week 29, I'm hoping to reach the 50k mark, and it has happened. I'm around 39,000 in the world. I still got my free hit that I'm thinking to use in game week 32, and I am planning for the next double game week, and I think that is double game week 34. My team looks good, so that's why I freed up the funds to start bringing in like Liverpool players and so on. So let's have a look at the team then. Kepa in goal with 8, got me 1 clean sheet out of the 2 doubles that he's got against Liverpool. Wasn't expecting him to get a clean sheet against Liverpool, but happy days. Ben Mee with 3, disappointment there. However, you know, Brentford defence helped me out before, you know, in game week 27, so I need to start thinking about removing them now. Trippier and Boltman, massive returns. Boltman especially, you know, being a little bit of a differential, has helped bring those ranks where I want it to be. I kept Gabriel, only 2 points from him. I'm okay from keeping him in for now. Yeah, just thought I'll leave some Arsenal players. Matoma with 14, as you can see, 7 in both of the games. Since I brought him in game 26, yeah, been performing really well, bringing the points that we need. And the fixtures are not too bad, you know, but they are a side that is on form, so anything can happen. Rashford was my captain, saving the day with 10 points. That's fine by me. You know, that helped out a lot with the overall ranks, getting himself one goal and two bonus points to his name. There's a clean sheet point in there as well. That helps out a lot with 24. Fernandes was the biggest disappointment here in my team. Watkins, since bringing in Watkins in, where was this? In game week 28. So this was a move where it was a bit risky, you know, removing Haaland, but it's paid off. You know, sometimes we make a decision, it works. Sometimes we make a decision and it doesn't work. And this decision worked amazingly. He's like returned the highest, like amazing amount of points. He's crazy. He's just performing really, really well. And I think he is the player that you have to have in your team now. You know, he's on form. And the fixtures still look good. And I'm thinking about captaining him against Nottingham Forest. That would be fantastic as a big differential, because not many people will go for him. Schlenker with 11. Happy days, you know. Really good return from him. Tony with 11. Scored the goal against Brighton. Got that free maximum bonus points. Nothing for Manchester United game though. And as you can see, my bench looks like this. I've got David De Gea with 8. Big differential, you know, getting a Manchester United defense, let's just say. 6 points from him, and the fixtures are looking good. I brought him in because I was looking at these fixtures. I was thinking, I do need a goalkeeper that has a double. So Manchester United has a double. Not bad double. So I thought, let me go for him. And plus, I needed the goalkeeper. Disappointment here, Saka was benched, only played 30 minutes, but the fixtures moving ahead, not too bad, and I'm quite happy to keep him actually, so it's okay. Henry with 3 is a player that I need to start removing really, or just leave him on the bench because he's, you know, 4.6, and I got a lot of money in the bank, so it doesn't really matter really. And I got McAllister here, that got me a goal against that Brentford game, 3-3, and 3 points for Bournemouth. There might be some injury issue with him, but we'll see. So that was my team. Very good. 138 points. Let's just say 134. Got me inside of the top 50k. Happy, happy days. And as you can see, the overall like game week rank was fantastic as well. Anyways, let's move on to game week 30. So this is how the team is looking like so far. No transfers yet, and I am thinking to remove Tony for Haaland. I've just tried my best to make the sensible moves, the obvious moves, and then when we have these doubles and free hits, I can bring in some differentials to push me to those ranks that I want to get to. I am 11 points behind, I think I am, behind game week, not game week, over rank of 25,000, so that's doable, you know, that is doable. So I'm hoping that this team can do it. So far, Rashford is my captain. However, when I bring in Haaland, I think I'm just going to captain Haaland instead. But we will see. We'll see what the press conference say. So I've got David De Gea in goal against Everton. Now, I could play Kepa. I do have some good bench options as well to help me out. But I think I'm going to go with David De Gea. You know, it's the first early game. Let's have a look at the fixtures. You know, it's the first early game. I think this is a good fixture for Manchester United to get some points from. Got Aston Villa, you know, against Nottingham Forest. You know, got Watkins. That's good. I could even go and get, like, one of the Aston Villa defence. So that might be a good option if I'm looking for a defender. You know, I've got some Brentford and Newcastle players. Hopefully this is a clean sheet game. That would be great. Maybe Leicester players could be good to get for against Bournemouth. That'd be a good option. Harry Kane is the only kind of the player that I'm a little bit afraid of, and a little bit of the Chelsea's defense, because a lot of people do have still like Chilwell and Reece James. And if I bring in like Haaland and captain him, I think that'd be good, and I'm happy with that. And this game really leads against Crystal Palace. I'm not really fussed, but here, you know, like Salah and Trent could be a problem, but I do have the two Arsenal players to negate that issue. But we'll see. So I'm actually okay going into this game week. So I've got Ben Mee and Trippier playing against each other, right? Hopefully one of them keeps a clean sheet. That would be fantastic. That's the kind of the game plan that I'm going with. I've got Gabriel. I could bring in like John Stones, and I could play like Henry or Botman, maybe Botman, go for that double Newcastle defence. But I'm okay with doing this. It's okay, but I don't know. We'll see. Things could change, right? If McAllister is injured or something, then I might have to play Botman. But we'll see. I got Mitoma and McAllister. I'm happy to play them against Tottenham, to be honest with you guys. I've got Saka against Liverpool. Never know what can happen, you know, against Liverpool these days. The defence is not that good, and Saka is on form. And I think the biggest gains where I'm going to be getting my points are, I think it's going to be from Manchester United and Watkins. Because at home against Everton is a good fixture. And I can see, hopefully, this is the game where Fernandes brings the points. And yeah, this is what I'm thinking to do. And I got Watkins against Nottingham Forest. Good fixture. And I think, yeah, even some people could even captain him as well. And Tony, as you can see, against Newcastle, but he is going to make way for Haaland, if Haaland is fit. So I got one transfer and I got 9.7 in the bank. So I'm definitely thinking to remove Tony, and as you can see, I've got quite a lot of money there, and people might be thinking, what the hell are you doing? Well, that's because I removed Harry Kane. So something like this, and I got 5.3. And with 5.3, you know, I'm thinking to remove Saka in the next game and bring in Salah in just like this. And I'm kind of set, really, you know, with a lot of double game week players. So these are some of the moves that I'm thinking to do. You know, I am then going to, you know, free hit in game week 32. And then I'm going to try my best to bank the transfer in game week 33. And then and fix up some defense, and then, you know, and go for this double game week fixture, because as you can see, there's quite a few fixtures here that some teams are playing twice. We'll go through that in the long run, but in another video. But for now, I think I'm just going to bring the Haaland. So it's going to be simple as that, and that is pretty much it. I'm inside the top 50k, guys. Hopefully, I can push onwards and get more green arrows and get closer to the top 25k, and then we'll see, right? We'll see. That last push, the free hits in game week 32 and the double game week 34 could be my way of getting inside of the top 10,000. Anyways, thank you so much for joining. I hope that this video has helped you. And yeah, see you guys next time, and enjoy your weekend. See ya.